like a typical day once you're in WASP and things are really moving? What was like a typical average day for you?
At first it was fun, you know, get up, typical, just have some breakfast or whatever. I'd make it down from Long Beach up to Hollywood, and we'd go over to Randy's, I think I mixed that up. Blackett would come down. Randy was in between us. I forget where his studio was, but I'd make it over there, and it was about the same amount of time for Blackett. We'd all make it over to Randy's, and we'd hang out in there, and he'd block time out on other bands, and it'd just be us. And we'd rehearse and write and spend hours in there, and it was pretty fun. And we'd go get something to eat or go shoot pool or drive up to Hollywood after that and just hang out. And pretty much those were good times, you know, when we were just getting to know each other and writing, and it was kind of exciting. And then seeing the other up-and-coming bands in the clubs, it was a cool thing.
Yeah.
Cool thing.
Cool vibe to be around, huh?
Mm-hmm. Once the business end came into it, it was rush, rush, rush. Hurry here, hurry there, sign this, sign that. You got to be there yesterday, you know. So things really started rolling along really fast after that. Did you talk to Steve Riley?
No, I haven't talked to Steve Riley.
He's a bud. I know him. He took my place, you know. That poor son of a bitch, he had about 2 weeks to learn a lot of my shit, and he was having a hard time. He told me that he was having a hard time with a lot of that stuff, and on some of the records, you can't really tell because he's playing it well, but he's playing it different, so it's hard to tell. So, but he did a damn good job, man.
Brittle bones, you are never sad.